And welcome back, guys. Welcome back to Let's Play Stalingrad with the Germans, no less. With the Germans. Last time we made a massive line, as you can see on the map, and we're getting close to our objective. We're that close. We avoided a huge amount of the enemy entrenchments, as you can see here, and hopefully we can keep that way, because the point is to capture this and GG for us all, right? As you can see, we have a massive amount of soldiers just waiting to be dropped somewhere, and I will be doing that immediately here. All these guys will be actually moving towards these locations here. Now we did set up some mines, as you can see also here. We have some, if you go over a mine, the AT mines are red, blue are anti-personnel mines, which actually do not exist. I mean, in the blue form they are all red, if I'm not mistaken. I could be mistaken, I usually am, so that you can, you know, anywho, we have a beautiful defense here just for in case if the enemy tries to do something very smart but not very unusual, like attacking us at some point with T-34s. We have seen the Ural Manufacturing one here that we have destroyed, but we do not know where the other guys are. Again, I don't like that the destruction is gone in this game. I don't know why. I don't know who said, like, you know what, we should remove the destruction effects and, you know, stuff like that. Thankfully, they don't remove dead bodies, but, you know, like, why? What's the point? Like, what, you know, like, it just kills the immersion. And whenever you reload, you lose those destruction, the holes on the ground and destruction. What the fuck? Doesn't really matter. Let's move on and finally capture this and finish the objective today, maybe. Maybe not. We'll take it slow. So again, I set up mine just in case if the enemy tries to bump us from behind, we'll know. Airstrike unavailable, of course. That's quite understandable, as we never had any airstrikes in those specific missions. Here we have a two SMG gunners, the MP40 personas. They're quite evil, I hear, because they have the MP40s. If you never knew that, now you know. I also have a bunch of units here positioned. You can hardly see them, sadly. I mean, it's kind of hard to see. They are, after all, sprites, and, you know, in the old games, you can barely see the sprites of evil. So let's move on with our Panzer IIIs. Here we have lots of Panzer IIIs. We have the Panzer IIIN, Panzer IIIL here. How I imagine that I actually remembered. Panzer IIIN has a flag, Panzer IIIL doesn't have a flag, so fuck it. Okay, moving on. We have the Panzer IV G, which is the best fucking tank, and that's what's actually Panzer IV F1, so fuck you, demon. Okay, this is a Panzer IV G. I should just read the fucking thing and just move on with my life. Okay, we have the Mauser 98 Carabiner. Yeah, so we shall move him around a little bit up front here. Let's see, do we have a good tank defense? That's the point here. Do we have a good tank defense? Look how many men we have. We're going to be sending our Roman infantrymen with the officer included towards the middle ground here. They're going to be leading the way. They're the command squad, though. And you can score. We have another regular squad here, a massive squad of pure evil. Let's close down under the ground. Let's go like this. That way we can avoid most of death and bullets and destruction, maybe. We have a sniper here with Mauser 98 SR, which is the only actually sniper rifle we have at the moment in this one. It's like I have only one officer and I'm keeping him alive, and that's a German officer of pure goodness. They are good people. So let's get these guys out of there. Let's get the Roman to overlook this position and see if we can see anything. I mean, this is quite similar to the, well, to be honest, in most missions in this second chapter, we're capturing stations left and right. We're following the road to Stalingrad. And I believe this is the last mission for this specific point. I mean, for this specific chapter, that is. So this is gonna be a GG for us all, probably. And then finally Stalingrad, maybe, you know, not just the outskirts of Stalingrad, Stalingrad itself, maybe at some point. I mean, the game is amazing, and I do want to see finally the last few battles of Stalingrad, where the evil Russians lost against the good Germans, the war is. But no, that's not how it's gonna go. So yeah, I mean, you have to follow the story, I guess, you know, like a story that is the historical thingy. You first play with the Germans, and then you play with the Russians, right? Because they all both have, like, the Russians continue, I believe, the moment where the German part ended. You know, and that's about it, in the game, that is. So if you're like, if you like to, like me, I like to follow the story, if you will. So I'll always go with canonical thingy, like how it goes, how it should be, that is. You never skip into the other kind of campaign that it doesn't make sense if you don't know the entire thing. Because I'm awesome like that, first and foremost. And the second thing is, I have that infantryman with the MG42. He can shoot you in the face, also, if need be. Let's see, we have the Panzer 3L, which will move a little bit closer here. Move a little bit closer here. Get the F1 and the G version. Slowly but surely, we are moving. But I'm a little bit worried that the side shot from someone in these locations could be very bad. So I'm gonna move my soldier specifically a little bit more here. We need support from you, which is a Panzer 4 F2. We have three great Panzers here. We have the F1, F2, and G version. They are our best fucking things that we have in this game at the moment. Let's get the officer here. Well, actually, that's just a regular Roman infantryman. Get him over here. So if he gets shot, we'll know. We'll freaking know. The APCs. Let's move some APCs. They're supposed to be guarding the tanks in terms of, you know, like, taking the bullet. Taking the freaking bullet for the tanks themselves. We have the T-34. We have these pathetic fucking Panzers here that I really don't want to utilize at all. So I'm going to move what we have. The Panzer 3... Oh, sorry. Renault R-35. And we have some APCs. Let's move them over here. Let's see what we have here. Another regular squad of infantrymen, which I'm not going to really utilize. I'm going to move slowly but surely and see what the fuck is happening up front. Because I can't really see what's happening up front. Can you see what's happening up front? I can't see what's happening up front. So let's get the officer a little bit between these two tanks. We have no officers here though. We will be needing one command squad maybe in these locations here. We have the MP40 SMG gun. He's standing. He doesn't give a shit. Whoever is here, he doesn't give a crap about him. And he doesn't give a crap about them being, you know, shooting him in the face. Maybe a facehugger will jump out of one of these boxes and eat him alive. But actually, it wouldn't. It would actually incubate inside of him and then sexually arouse him. And then he will burst open and someone will die. Probably a chest burster. He will die. Now, that aside. There are no aliens in this game, though. Kind of bummer, but, you know, just quite understandable. There were no aliens in Stalingrad, you know. At least that's what they say, but I don't believe it. Okay. So let's move the Roman squad, which is so fucking awesome, you know. Like, these guys are so useless. These fuckers are fresh meat for the butcher. You know, it's just, here you go, you like having this, let's go, the ZB whatever rifles you have, let's get inside that, you get there, let's, again, go on the ground just for in case and keep the officer alive, unless I move the officer somewhere else. No, there is the officer with a black cap of awesome, because he's Romanian, or actually Italiano, I have no idea, it says Roman, you know, it could be Romanian for short, though I don't think that is, so probably it's just Italiano troops. He doesn't sound Italiano. He doesn't even have a voice. Yeah, he doesn't even have a voice. Let's just call them the aliens. The mutants. The heretic. You know, for the German army, these guys, that they were dead for sure. Okay, we have our Red Army cargo containers. And there you go. Oh my god, a KV-1. Well, of course it's gonna be a KV-1, you fool! It's gonna be the biggest fucking monster ever. Well, can we actually kill him from with our artillery? Because I truly do not want to waste this ammo, but to be honest, yeah. Kinda I want to do that. At the end of the day, I'm not gonna risk it. I'm just gonna kill him off from the distance if possible and not aggro him in any motherfucking way. And there is another Uralmash factory, but the KV-1 is much more dangerous. We have seen him last time. He can open some asses. He is he's a very strong beast of burden. He likes to eat children. I'm hoping for that one precise shot like the last fucking time, but we'll utilize this one for the T-34. I'm just gonna waste those artillery guns anyway. I mean, we have a sniper for the rest of the things. The problem here is that we don't have any more supplies, so this could be a total waste. You know, it could be a total waste. We'll see. I mean, if T-34 can be opened, that would be nice. I don't want to lose one fucking tank, because I have no idea why. I just don't want to lose them. I mean, who knows how many things they actually have and killing that KV-1 would be a perfect opportunity. I mean, the armor up and armor up like on the freaking not on the side, and that 67 is the side, that's the rear, that is 35 is the upper armor, so the penetration value would be immense if we hit the nice shot again. But yeah, it's not going well, which is okay, I guess. At least we tried, and that's not something I mind. At least we tried. Not huge amount of ammo left, I presume, or at all. Yeah, and no more bombing. Yeah, empty. Empty, almost empty. Yeah. Thank you! Thank you! How you're so fucking good! Like, look at that, that's a perfect, again, kill him at least. That one didn't do shit. I mean, I probably hit him, but again, he's still at full health. But maybe this one will do a perfect job against KV and actually open his ass. Let's hope he does. No ammo. Okay, well, you tried, but that's okay. The KV-1 will be a problem, but as long as we have a lot of infantrymen all around, we'll be able to surround him and shoot him in the face. So that means that I'll have to a little bit get closer. We have to set up a nice defensive position against him. So I'm gonna move the F2 version here to the side, get the APCs up front here. I'm gonna lure that fucker if I can. If not, it doesn't really matter. You have the Romanian with their infantry rifle, which of course is not gonna do anything against the KV, but just saying. Save here like a little bitch again, because this is gonna be one of those pivotal moments of knowing what the fuck the enemy actually has inside there, because again, they're probably gonna have a lot of fucking things, like a lot of enemy infantry and a lot of enemy tanks. As they did say in the report, they probably do have a lot of enemy everything. The range is massive here, as you can see here, so we really don't need to get close to him as long as we have a sight towards him. Now, as I said, this is a Blitzkrieg engine, and something that is the biggest mistake is that the freaking tanks still have a big sight radius, even without infantry. So that's one of those big no-nos to me in games. Like, there's a Scheissenberger! Yay, Scheissenberger, our secondary sniper, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, that's our secondary sniper. That's a Scheissenberger. Let's get this guy over here. Let's get the APC to this location. Now we'll find out what the hell is going on in this orchard of evil. Maybe go over this location, overlook this location. I don't know. I don't care. At least I kill some of the T-34 Uralmash factory. Yeah. A big boys, a big kahunas, an evil thing of pure goodness. Now, why am I positioning it? But now this side we have three tanks, and this side we front with the KV-1 with my move towards these guys. We have three guys, we'll shoot him in the face from the sides, and he's dead. Again, a long ranger. It's all about the long motherfucking ranger. Hopefully we can keep that way. Of course, we're gonna try and avoid, not make it like a massive here. We're gonna like try and avoid overly too much. Like on these sides, if they do have more tanks like position here, we want to try to avoid them completely, but the AI might move them. The AI might move them towards the location where they're noticing that there's something is happening, right? So these guys where they are now are useless. So we can move them finally towards these locations. Get this build. No, that's not a command squad. Command squads usually are about 5 man to 6 man. So in this game at least. So we are getting close, we are getting very close to the end, we are getting very motherfucking close to the end. Getting very close, but we need an insight towards these locations. Now if I could remember where most of my freaking, yeah, there he goes, the officers. It's all about the officer, you need insight. You're gonna move that officer because we have barely any officers, actually we have no officers on the completely left side here. You're gonna move this officer, this Romanian, Italiano, whatever this fucker. Oh, actually that's a, yes, it is a Roman officer. So yeah, you're gonna move him towards these locations, and then we're gonna overlook this locations, and there's absolutely nothing in those locations, so we're gonna overlook at these locations, and we're gonna see most of things because of these locations, but we should understand down the line what the fuck is happening. Okay, so yeah, we lost the sight towards the freaking KV. That's totally okay. I have no problem with that. Because at the end of the day, he will be moving, and what can you do? You know what? What can you do? Nothing. You can't do shit. Let's get move the APC towards this location, to this location, and then let's see, what do we have? We have the command tank, which will move towards this location here. It's gonna be perfect for this location, because his is totally fucking useless. That command tank is as useless as three girls and no cups of tea, okay? Just saying. And there goes the T-34. Oh, there you go, another command squad. Excellent, excellent. Exactly what we actually needed, another command squad, so we can overlook, you know, all the locations. Have a nice 180 degree towards the enemy, at least, if nothing else, you know. I mean, of course, why, you know, that's the point where we're gonna overlook most of things. Something coming from these roads, coming from the, of course, from the railway station itself, and of course coming from these locations, which we probably can even see what the fuck is happening there. That's why I'm gonna be moving most of my soldiers towards these locations. Here. We have this full squad here that I'd barely even use. Another big massive squad. Again, dispersing these guys would be much more preferable, but I'm gonna leave them between some of our tanks just for in case. Now, let's see. We have a command squad, I believe, here somewhere. Thank you very much. Get over here. The Scheissenberger will go over here. Get this guy, Romanian bastards, over here. I'm gonna just call him Romanian, fuck it. And let's see what's happening. Okay, so there is still a KV-1 issue, which of course we're getting close to it. We're very close to it. We could utilize the 80 guns actually for this specific asshole. Yeah, we could utilize the KV-1s for this specific asshole. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do that. Yeah, 80 guns. Get the 80 guns here. Position them so he can will actually concentrate on the 80 guns, maybe. If nothing else. Or this T-34. T-34, I mean, I'm not caring much for him. But I do want to keep most of my things alive as long as possible, you know. Okay, let's get you, whatever you truly are. A Panzer 3J. Yeah, we have those also. We have a lot of many. Can we overlook this location? Now let's move the officer, because we are losing the site towards this specific location. This house could be full of soldiers. Could be very much full of soldiers, and we have no idea. Okay, nothing there, but I'm gonna overlook this area specifically. Excellent. Beautiful look. If they try to outflank us, we'll know, finally. Let's get you. Again, the smaller tanks, the most useless tanks will go up front. The big guys, the big kahunas will go in the back. And that way we can screw around with the enemy tank as much as we fucking want, if need be. And I mean, as soon as they know we are here, the KV will be moving. And I am pretty freaking afraid of KVs. I mean, again, we only had one battle with him, but he screwed himself over and exposed his flank, which of course was a total downer for him, and he got owned. But that was because he got stuck on one of the dead wreckages of the of his own allies, the T-34s. So now that we're done with that, we're gonna get that and get this. I'm gonna position them in front, so, well, actually to the side maybe here, so that when he moves, we have a nice shot of a lot of freaking 75s opening fire upon his positions and killing him. Plus, we don't know, maybe they have more. Quite a big possibility they have actually more freaking stuff there. Well, yeah, there it goes. We have another officer that is completely useless where he truly is. So we're gonna shift-click him over here, shift-click him over here, and shift-click, where the fuck am I gonna put you? I'm gonna go back here. And now we can move our trucks. Excellent. As soon as we move them and position them, we can move in toward the KV and the main railway station. Because, again, could be that they have more stuff, more KVs, not just one, and I do believe that they probably have more KVs. And I want to keep the sniper alive as long as possible, because he is first and foremost a sniper. And he can kill off any crew, any AA crew, or any kind of AT crew without even getting close with the soldiers themselves. Even though, mind you, we do have a lot of soldiers as a backup plan, if need be, if we do lose everything else. So that's never a problem, shouldn't at least not be an issue. But these guys will get a nice hit from the freaking KV. He will shoot at these bastards and probably kill most of these soldiers that are in front if we don't have any kind of sight, should I say, radius towards him. So what Lebuck doing here is moving first and foremost some of our beautiful Mauser 98 carbine up here. Thank you. Let's go down. Let's see. We have a big squad here. We have an individual soldier here. We're gonna be moving him towards this location. Maybe he's gonna overlook something over here through these cracks. May he see something evil? Maybe not. We'll see. Okay, we're positioning the AT gun here. And positioning the AT gun here. I mean, the side shots would be more perfect, I believe, than anything else. Yeah, I believe the side shots would be the perfect ones, actually. So I'm gonna move this truck over here. Get the fuck out. Let's see the range first and foremost on our pack. Actually, 50mm. They're not the biggest, but it's a okay, because they're pack 50s. I'm gonna actually position them like here to the sides. Okay, to the sides like this, like a boss, and hit them to the side, and he's gonna be dead. I mean, he's completely gonna be like totally destroyed because of this fact. And I made again buildings quite big possibility. They have a lot of soldiers there. So I should have actually utilized your AT guns for that, but that's okay. I mean, this way we at least killed some Wurlmash factory bastards, and that's fine with me. He actually does have ammo on him. Wow, really? You do have ammo? Really, really, guys? Since when? I was thinking most of you guys didn't have any ammo. Ooh, this could be actually quite beneficial for the artillery guns. Okay, let's get these guys back here, and get them back here, and feed these bastards. Oh yeah, I do have another squad here. Wow, I have a lot of squads, a lot of infantry squads that will be needing them for this specific operation. And get them over here. Again, just if the enemy does something good. You know, if he does something good, we need that nice insight towards the enemy. Excellent. Now we can save here and lure the enemy if need be. Thank you very much, guys. Thank you very much. Gonna use the APC for this. Hey, KV, douchebag, come on, asshole, you see me, do you see me, come on, you see me, he doesn't care, he truly doesn't give a shit, does he? That's okay, you don't care, well, you know what, I care, so, maybe we can move a little bit closer now. Because we know that the enemy doesn't have an insight towards this towards us. We're that close. So that means I can move freely my soldiers and my freaking tanks a little up closer here. Be awesome like nobody's bitch. Gonna actually entrench this one for in case if the enemy comes from these locations. You want a good side shots upon the enemy first and foremost, and secondly just for in case if shit happens. You know, just for in case if the shit happens. Oh, well, look at this. This is a range of Panzer 4, right? He will open asses. He will open some asses here. It's all about the ranges. Now, I don't know the ranges of KV-1. But the ranges of our guys, I think it's perfect. Almost can't pierce the armor. Great. That's okay. That's okay. Let's move a little bit closer. Okay, someone is opening fire upon us. Oh, that's the KV-1. Finally. Will he move towards us? Yes, he is. He's actually following that one soldier. He wants him dead. He doesn't like, it would seem, the Mauser 98K guys. Let's close in on that. Thank you very much. Yes, KV, yes, move. Open fire from one of our 50mm things. Excellent. Excellent, excellent. Side shots upon the KV. Excellent shot by the Panzer 4G. Oh, they want that car in 98 Persona. Like, they really want him, you know, like... Fall back. Don't get killed, Panzer 4G. Hold ground, guys. I said hold ground, you fool, for fuck's sake. Thank you, he's dead, he's dead, he's dead. It's okay, it's okay. Everybody, hold the fucking ground. Wait a little bit, for fuck's sake. Jesus. Okay, we did it. There is a, oh shit. Oh shit, oh shit. Oh shit, the enemy has them Nubelwerfers. Go, 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 go. Move a little bit. We killed the KV-1, killed the Euromash, let's kill him now. Gonna move our tanks a little bit up close. Avoid another volley of their freaking awesome weapons of mass destruction. At least we did not lose many other things. Let's move in. Move in, guys. Move in with the soldiers. Move in. Well, not that much move in. I mean, they do have a lot of stuff probably out there. Okay, that freaking Katyushka got destroyed, thankfully. And there is an AA gun, actually, right there. Okay, something is shooting at us, except not just the 8, oh, it is the 88, okay, so the 88 is, well, the 85mm 80 gun is shooting at us. Fall back a little bit, thank you very much. We lost the sniper. Is Scheissenberger still alive, is the question here. Is Scheissenberger still alive? No, he's not. Ah, man, see, the fucking rockets... Like, they fell exactly on the bad spot. Like, exactly where we really didn't want them, like, to fall. That was bad. That was fucking bad. Like, we lost the entire squad almost here. We didn't even kill the 88, 85 crew, that is. If we tried to charge into them, we could actually destroy them completely, but without knowing what exactly they have. It would be kind of stupid to do that. But we did lose a lot of stuff here. We lost an officer. We lost a sniper. Yeah, sniper is dead. We have a lot of soldiers. Oh, wait. We do have another officer here. Thankfully. Thankfully, I say. Let's get these guys a little bit over here. Let's find an officer if I can. There you go. There's an officer. Get him a little bit closer towards these locations. And move in. As soon as we kill the 85, we can freely move in with most of our stuff. I believe. There you go. The 85mm AA gun. We don't have any artillery now. Well, at least we will be actually having one of them. Let's feed. Excellent. We feed him at least one bullet. Oh fuck. He was like constantly firing at one position, then yeah. And he's very strong. He actually kills stuff. Unbelievable. He actually kills stuff. He has an insight because of Oh, thank you. A nice shot. Thank you very much. We'll charge you in immediately now. Warning, do you want to overwrite something? I don't know what am I overwriting, but it was probably a save. So we can move in. We can freely move in. Those 80 guns were perfection where they were, though. We cannot repair the Panzer 4G, just saying. Gonna move our soldiers over this location. And what I'm gonna do here is only move my tank. They're gonna clear out the mess that is here. With the, of course, the APCs and stuff like that. Get over here, move attack command, that is. Get a little bit closer here. Get the Panzer IV here. And that's gonna be it. I believe there's gonna be a perfect, perfect opportunity to kill off most of the enemy infantry. Maybe. I mean, T-34 I don't care for, so he can just charge in with him. Get over here. Thank you very much. Get over here with Panzer IIIs. The L version and the N version. Let's tell these guys to move attack command towards these locations. They probably have a lot of stuff here. We do not see them as of yet, though. We lost some things. We gain other things, I guess. Let's get the officer around this position so I can overlook a little bit more than what we actually are seeing. I mean, there are a lot of enemy soldiers. I'm not worried about them because I have tanks right in front of them. Like, right in front of them, we have a bunch of tanks ready to do the good, the bad, and the ugly if need be. Sadly, I cannot repair the Panzer IV, but as long as something doesn't come from these locations, it's a-okay. T-34, can you do your job? Please, get a little bit closer. Thank you. Excellent. So only like two guys, three guys left, one guy left. Excellent. As soon as he dies, probably this is going to be all ours. Maybe. If not, that means that there are a bunch of more soldiers around these positions. Yeah. No. I'm awesome. And you're not. Ooh! A War Merit Cross First Class. Soldier of Wehrmacht, for your bravery on the battlefields of the Eastern Front, command decided to award you with War Merit Cross 1 Class. War Merit Cross 1 Class was awarded to military men whose acts of courage were above the call of duty, which is not the game, yet did not meet the criteria for the Iron Cross. War Merit Cross 1 Class required previous award War Merit Cross 2 Class. There was a variant of Merit Cross 1 Class without swords, which was awarded to non-combatant men who directly supported something, the Wehrmacht, and were employed in war-related industries. Wow. War Merit Cross was worn on the left breast pocket. Over 483,000 soldiers and officers of Wehrmacht were awarded with War Merit Cross 1 Class. Excellent. Let's see our results. As you can see, we got all the rewards. Yay! Let's see. Did we get anything? We actually lost. Wow. How the fuck do I just don't get it. I lose on supply support, about to meet troops needs of call. Fuck off. Minus 8 and minus 1 on character building. Like, what the fuck is that? Character building. Built to effectively command units lower casualty. I barely lost anything. I fucking barely lost anything. How the fuck? Who cares? And finally, approaching Stalingrad, look at where we are. Like, even we're still not dead. We're still not there, like, for fuck's sake. I mean, we are there, but not there. Oh my god, chapter 3, approaching Stalingrad, August, September 1988. I wish you the very best, guys. I wish you the very best.